Welcome all of you to my YouTube channel Statistics and Data Science. Please don't forget to subscribe my channel and hit the bell icon to get notification of my new videos. So in this tutorial we are going to see the hyperparameter optimization of the k nearest neighbor algorithm. Here we try to obtain the best value for k, that is total number of neighbors. So in previous tutorial we see that how to apply k nearest neighbor algorithm on a classification data. Here we apply k nearest neighbor algorithm on iris dataset, consist of species as a target variable having three classes. So this is the required procedure to apply the machine learning algorithm k nearest neighbor. You have to see my tutorial about the k nearest neighbor algorithm to know more about that. In this tutorial we are going to see how to obtain the best k value for our KNN machine learning algorithm. For that, we try to obtain a k value using error. The k value which having minimum error, it will be taken to be in our algorithm. So try to obtain the minimum value of error and try to take the k nearest neighbor, that is k value, for that particular minimum error. So for that we try to make a function. First of all we try to make a directory of error, that is empty directory or empty list. After that we are going to make a function for ranging between 1 to 60. For I in range of 1 to 60, I take values between 1 to 60. After that we try to fit k nearest neighbor algorithm, and inside that we take nearest neighbor equals to I take value between 1 to 60. After that we try to fit it on training data set, that is X train and Y train, and we try to predict on it X test data set. You can see, and if error is nothing but the mean of the misclassified data, that is predicted I is not equals to, this is the symbol for not equals to Y test. If our model predicted value and our original value are not equal, then the mean of all these value is taken to be error. That error is basically here is nothing but average of all misclassified observation. You can say when we see confusion matrix, here we can see the average of off diagonal elements. Here error is basically average of off diagonal elements, that is average of misclassified data, and we try to obtain the minimum error, and here we use total number of k nearest neighbor ranging between 1 to 60. We try to put the values for k between 1 to 60 and try to check the error for each value, and which having minimum error which will be taken in our algorithm. So let's execute our command line. After that we are going to plot our graph, that is graph of error, and for particular k value, k values is on x axis, that is here you can see we try to plot using plt.plot function, and after that range is basically our k values are ranging between 1 to 60, and here our error is basically our data. Error is nothing but average of all misclassified observation for each k value are between 1 to 60. After that these are the basic arguments. Color is red, line style is dashed, maker is O, and maker face color is blue, maker size is 10. After that we are going to apply the title of our graph, error rate for k value, and x label will be k value and y label will be mean error. So let's execute our command line. You can see here we can see these values, these are the on x axis we have k values and y axis we have mean error, that is our error. So you can see these observations having minimum error. Here we can see from 3-2 up to 17 we have minimum error. So we can say the value between 3 to 17 as a we can take it as a k value. We can take any value between 3 to 17 as a k value, we get better accuracy from our model. That time we can get better accuracy when we put n neighbors equals to numbers between 3 to 17. That time we can get best value as our it having minimum error. So when we take k values between say 3 to 17, that time we can get minimum error, and other k values having maximum error. You can see when we take 50, then we have maximum error. So this is the graph for error versus k. K is on x-axis and error is on y-axis. So these observations having these k values having minimum error, so it can take in our algorithm. So this is the one method. After that, we are going to see the another method using random search CV. We try to obtain the best k value using random search CV. So first of all, we try to obtain or try to import our random search CV library from sklearn.modelSelection. So after that, we try to make an array of 60 numbers between 60 random numbers between 1 to 50. So we try to define the parameters. Here we take only one parameters because we want only total number of neighbors, that is best value for k. So after that, we make we try to make a list of parameters. Here we make an array of 60 numbers. So this is basically n neighbors is basically an array of 60 numbers, and we try to apply the random search CV on our classifier. Classifier is our original KNL algorithm. Parameters, you can see parameters are nothing but these total number of neighbors ranging from 1 to 50, and we have total 60 numbers between 1 to 50. That is total k values. So this is the parameters. N iteration will be 5, cross validation fold will be 5, n jobs will be -1, and verbose equals to 0. Here we can see we assign cross validation folds will be 5. This is the main model for random search CV. After that, we try to fit our random search CV model on Xtrain and Ytrain dataset, and here after that we try to print the accuracy for our training dataset as well as testing dataset using this random search CV. So let's execute our command line. Random search CV is quietly less time consuming. Basically, it gives result in very less time. So that's why random search CV having one advantage of it take less time to run our algorithm. So you can see training dataset having accuracy score 97% and testing dataset having accuracy score 96%. So we try to obtain the best k value, nothing but best number of neighbors for our KNN machine learning algorithm. So let's execute our command line. So you can say best nearest neighbor value will be 7. As we can see in this, when we try to obtain the best k value using error, that time we can say between 3 to 17 we have best k value, and after that we try to obtain the k value using random search CV. Random search CV also gives the best value 7. It lies between 3 to 17. Basically, you can take values between 3 to 17 to get better accuracy on this IRIS dataset. So it is specifically for IRIS dataset. If you take another dataset, that time you can get another result. So this is the required procedure to obtain the best k value for our KNN machine learning algorithm using this error method. We try to obtain a function make a function of error, and after that we try to plot a graph of error versus our k values, and we try to obtain best k value having minimum error, and after that we see the obtain the best k value using random search CV. So this is the required procedure to apply the random search CV algorithm. First of all, we have to make a list of parameters. Here we have n neighbors as our parameter, and we assign the list between 1 to 50, ranging from 1 to 50, having 60 number between that. And this is the basic random search CV algorithm. After that, we try to fit random search CV algorithm on training dataset and check the accuracy on training dataset as well as testing dataset. And as random search CV is basically very less time consuming, so this is one of the best advantage of random search CV. and you can see we get our best n-bus value, that is best k value is 7. So this is the required procedure to obtain the best k value for KNN machine learning algorithm. So thank you all of you. Please subscribe my channel and hit the bell icon to get notification of my new videos. Thank you all of you.